This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is video 2 in our series of solving equations with grouping symbols, such as parentheses and brackets. In fact, we have both of them in this particular equation. So we begin solving equations by simplifying each side. So on the left side, we see we have parentheses, so we're going to have to do the distributive property here. So that's our first step over on the left side, is to distribute that 2, so that we have 2 times 5, which is 10, minus 2 times 3x, which is 6x. And now on the right, you have to be careful here. It is true there's a 5 and there's a bracket instead of parentheses, and that's because there are parentheses further inside. So what we want to do here is we want to simplify on the inside of those brackets as much as possible before we distribute that 5. That isn't the only way to do it, but I think it's easier for most people, so let's do it that way. So inside, I'm going to have to distribute this 2, and it's really a negative 2, right? To the x into the negative 2. So I'm going to just copy up through there, and now I have negative 2 times x, that'll be a minus 2x. And I've got a negative 2 times a negative 2 really ends up being a plus 4. And notice, I haven't simplified within the brackets yet. So I'm just going to copy the left-hand side here. Now, since there are no more parentheses, instead of writing brackets, I could just change and write that grouping symbol with parentheses. You could keep it as brackets if you want. In fact, these brackets could have been parentheses, but it sort of helps people keep track of, you know, what goes together where. So if we combine like terms here, I've got 2 plus 4, that's 6, and then I have the minus 2x still. So I still have to simplify the right-hand side by doing the distributive property with a 5 now. So I still have 10 minus 6x, and now I have 5 times 6 is 30, minus 5 times 2x is 10x. Okay, I finally got rid of all those grouping symbols, and now I'm down to solving an equation where we've got variables and constants on each side. How about we put the constants on the left-hand side? So I'm going to add 10x to both sides. And so I'm going to, how about subtracting this 10? So I have the constants on the right-hand side. So I'm adding a negative 10 plus 10x to both sides of the equation. So over on the left-hand side, I'll end up with just 4x, because negative 6 plus 10, you're just going to add those coefficients, is 4x. And on the right-hand side, I have 30 minus 10, because the negative 10x and plus 10x is 0, right? So I get 4x equals 20. All right, so now we're almost done. Just divide both sides by 4, and we end up with x equals 5. Now, I said at the beginning of this, you could distribute your 5 first. So I'm also going to show you how to do it that way, but I'll do that at the end of the video for those of you who don't want to know and just want to go ahead and do the innermost grouping first, the distributive property in the inside first, which is the most common way of doing it. So let's go ahead and check this answer, x equals 5. All right, so we're going to check 5. So we're going to replace x with 5. So instead of x there, I'm going to put times 5. And I'm going to simplify within the parentheses first, right? Because now we're just simplifying this expression. And so inside the parentheses, I have to do this multiplication first. Do not do 5 minus 3 first, okay? Multiplication before the subtraction. So I have 5 minus 15, which, if it helps you, you could think of that as 5 plus a negative 15. That's up to you. And within parentheses, I'm adding a positive and a negative number. And there's more negatives, so it's negative 10, right? And we have 2 times negative 10. Positive times negative is negative, so I get negative 20 on the left-hand side. Okay, now let's work on the right-hand side. So we're going to start by just copying everything but plugging in 5 for x. And now we're going to simplify this by working within the innermost parentheses first. No distributive property, right? So I have 2 minus 2 parentheses. What's 5 minus 2? 3. Okay, now I have to simplify within these brackets still, and I've got this multiplication, this 2 times 3. Make sure, again, you don't do 2 minus 2 first. You're doing order of operation. That's a multiplication. Multiplication before subtraction. So I could keep this as a bracket, or I could do it parentheses. I'm going to keep it bracket for a moment. That's 2 minus 6. And now I'm going to just put a parentheses. You could keep it as a bracket. It doesn't matter. All right, 2 minus 6, you could think of as 2 plus negative 6. And so you're adding a positive and a negative number. So there's more negatives. You're going to have negative 4. And then 5 times negative 4 is negative 20. So that's what the check looks like. I think it might be longer to check than just do the problem over. It checks. So this is the correct answer. So our solution, if we want to write it in braces, would be 5. That would be the solution to that problem. All right, for those of you that are still with me, I'm going to show you how you could distribute your 5 first, but you got to be really careful here. So on the left side, we could still do the distributive property, get the 10 minus 6x. But when you distribute the 5 here, you got to be careful. There's only really 2 terms, the 2, and this whole thing over here is another term. So when you distribute, you're just distributing to that whole term right there. So that'll give you 5 times 2, which is 10, and then you have 5 times this stuff. So you're just doing the 5 times 2 first and 10 and just writing the x minus 2. You have to be careful you don't put an extra 5 times that x minus 2. So as I said, this could be a little more confusing, distributing the 5 first. It is not the way it's usually taught, but I just want to show you that if you're careful, you could also do that. Now we're going to distribute the minus 10, so it's a negative 10x plus 20, and the rest of it begins looking like our other problem. 10 plus 20 is 30 minus 10x, and from here it looks exactly like the other problem did before we finished the problem. So I'm going to finish this quickly. We just add the 10x to both sides, and we subtract the 10 to get 4x equals 20, which also gives you the answer of x equals 5, which we already checked and know that's the correct answer. So that just gives you an alternate way. I don't suggest that you do that. I think it's better to work with in parentheses first. But I like to show that there's always more than one way to go about solving a problem. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.